It is Monday, the 8th of June 2020, and welcome to another trip report. This trip report will be out about a small local train that runs from Aachen in Germany to Maastricht in the Netherlands. It's not a long distance, but it's an international train. It's a ride of approximately 1 hour. Well, as always, I first show you the station where I'm departing from, which is Aachen in this case, Aachen main station. After that, I show you the train, and after that, I show you some views from the train. There will be another video where I will feature the railway station of Maastricht. Anyway, when you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button. And please give me a thumbs up when you like this video. Enjoy the video. Okay, please note, I recorded this video during the COVID-19 pandemic. But I also want this to be helpful for you when you make this journey and let's say 5 years from now. So in the video I will just act like there's nothing going on, but you will see a lot of people wearing face masks, see some warnings everywhere. But once again, I also want this to be helpful for you when you make this journey in let's say 5 years time from now.
This is the route of my train today. My train will go from Aachen in Germany to Maastricht in the Netherlands. Officially, this train was also planned to go to Liège from Maastricht in Belgium, but because there is not a lot of cooperation from the Belgian side, the terminal station is at this moment Maastricht. To make things a little bit more clear, I took a picture of the European railway map covering this area. The section between Maastricht and Liège is at this moment being served by the Belgian state-owned railway company. When you're traveling between Belgium and Germany, the best thing is to take a train that will cross this border as well. There are two lines between Liège and Aachen. One conventional railway line and one high-speed line, what is the purple line. This high-speed line is a part of the Brussels-Cologne high-speed line. A section of the route I'll be taking today is also listed as a scenic route, as you can see here on the green line on the east part of Heerlen. At the end of the video, I'll get back to the original plans of the extension to Belgium. For now, let's go back to Aachen main station, my departure station. Literally all trains that run between Belgium and Germany will call at this station. This is quite an international railway station. You'll find, for example, the Thalys that runs between Germany and France, but also the Nightjet that runs between Belgium and Austria, and of course my train that runs every hour between Aachen and Maastricht. At the side of the railway station you'll find a big taxi stand like you just saw. Lots of local and regional buses do stop here as well. There are also buses directly from the Netherlands to here. And just like in more and more other cities, you also find some companies for e-steps. I really like this one, by the way, where you can wirelessly charge your phone while you're navigating. In a way, I really like this e-steps, but I do have some mixed feelings about them. On the side of the railway station, you also find this bike sharing program. I think these are all electric bikes. Near the station, you'll find some hotels, supermarkets, etc. And the city center is within 10 minutes walking from the railway station. You can also take a bus, of course. Aachen Hauptbahnhof has been built in 1905. During the Second World War, this railway station has been bombed, and after the Second World War, it has been rebuilt. In 2005, this station has been renovated. In the main hall, you'll find one vending machine of the Belgian Railway Company and one vending machine of Arriva Limburg, which is for a part of the Netherlands. You can charge your Dutch OV chip card here as well. Since you'll find Dutch buses here as well, this might also be very useful for when you're traveling with a Dutch bus to the Netherlands. An OV chip card is a kind of smart card for public transport in the Netherlands. When you're traveling with this specific train, where I'm traveling on today, you can also use your OV chip card to travel to here. Aachen is a Dutch fare point. This train does have two more other stops in Germany, and at those stops you also find an OV chip card reader. So actually you can travel with your Dutch OV chip card in Germany on this line as well. In that case, you're only allowed to travel on trains of Arriva Limburg. In the main hall you'll also find a travel center. Here you find some vending machines and there are some ticket desks where you can buy long distance and also regional tickets. Tickets for example the Thalys trains can be booked here as well. Of course, in the main hall you also find vending machines for the German railway company. In the main hall you'll find several shops, a drugstore, some fast food restaurants, a bookshop, etc. When you're walking to the platforms, you will find a big screen that will indicate the departing trains from here. At the beginning of the tunnel that will guide you to the railway tracks, you'll find a locker room. Toilets can be found at the opposite direction of the locker room. There are no escalators in this railway station, but all platforms are easy accessible by stairs and elevator. Since the exit is in the main hall, there isn't much to direct to, but directions for what facilities can be found where are clearly given throughout the station. Time to go to my train. Today I'll be traveling with the RE18 of Arriva Limburg, and this train runs every hour between Maastricht and Aachen, and every 30 minutes between Maastricht and Heerlen. RE stands for Regional Express, so this means local express train. This means it doesn't stop everywhere, but it's not an intercity. The old name for this in the Netherlands used to be fast train, so sneltrein. Actually, in the Netherlands, this train is also listed as sneltrein. Screens at the platform will give clear indications on when this train will depart, and also arriving trains will be displayed here. The trains being used for this route are the Flirt trains made by Stadler. I guess these are one of the most common trains you can find in Europe, and especially for shorter distances. The trains on this route are not very big, they consist of 3 carriages. While the trains to Germany are not that frequently, there's only one per hour, on the Dutch section of the route and especially between Heerlen and Maastricht, you'll find quite a lot of trains. Approximately one train on every 15 minutes. The Netherlands is known for very frequent trains in general. Facilities and route information is all very clear displayed on the side of the train. Also at the front and the back of the train, you'll find some route information. Time to board and show you the interior of these trains. I'll start off by showing you the second class. Well, first class isn't that big anyway, because the first class only hosts 12 seats. Something I really like are these couches in the middle of the second class. Although these couches look really nice, the seating comfort of these couches isn't the best. I prefer the regular seats. Both first and second class comes in a 2x2 configuration, so two chairs on both sides of the aisle. At the very front or the very back of the train, depending which way you move, you'll find the quiet zone. In the quiet zone, you'll find 8 chairs, and those chairs do have a bigger table in between you can fold out. All the other chairs that are facing each other do have a small window table. Apart from the folding chairs, all chairs do have a power plug and a USB plug. About half of the chairs in second class are facing each other, and half of the chairs comes in a composition like this. The seats can't be reclined, but the leg space is really good. You also find a fold-out table in the chair in front of you. Throughout the train, you'll find lots of screens that will give you route information and travel suggestions. At the chairs that are facing each other, you'll find a small garbage can under the table near the window. Bigger garbage cans can be found near the entrances and the exits of this train. In the middle coach, near the entrance for disabled people, you'll find a toilet. Of course, this toilet is wheelchair friendly and therefore also pretty big. You can also use it as a nursery space for babies. My experience with Arriva in the south of the Netherlands, so Limburg, is very limited, but the times I traveled with them, it happened quite often that the toilets were not in use. I think the toilet was broken at those moments. But on national routes, Arriva Limburg will pretty often use 2 train sets, so you can simply jump on the next station to another train set. Luggage racks can be found pretty much all over the train, in both first and second class. You'll find some extra space for your luggage between some chairs. At the very front or the very back of the train, depending which way you move, you'll find the first class. First class hosts 8 seats with a table in between, and you'll find 4 seats with a composition like this. You do have a little bit more leg space, but personally I found the comfort level of these chairs less good than in second class. Something you will find here and won't find in second class is a personal reading light for all chairs and a sunscreen. There is some extra space for luggage behind the last row in the first class. Announcements for stations are all made in Dutch, German and French. Free Wi-Fi is available. It's just an internet connection. There's no entertainment or route information system connected to this. For route information, you can use the very detailed screens in the train and the apps, of course. For the next approximately 1 minute, I'll show you some views from the train. I'll also show you a bit more of the railway station of Valkenburg. After that, I get back to the original extension to Belgium. Maastricht is the terminal station of this train. In another video, I'll show you more of Maastricht railway station. This video, I'll be taking the longest single possible journey you can take in the Netherlands from Maastricht to Den Helder. From here, you can take lots of other trains to the Netherlands, but also trains to Belgium. This is the train that runs to Belgium and will go to Liège. Officially, the train I just took was planned to go to Belgium as well, so it was planned to take over this route. This was actually going to be the very first local line that was not being owned by the Belgian state-owned railway company. When everything has been made ready to start the service, the Belgium railway authorities came with new requirements. The Arriva trains should have more newer safety systems. Actually, safety systems that these trains don't have as well. This safety system is called ERMTS and is obligated from 2025. The Belgian railway company just said they will follow the new European guidelines. Arriva was planning to install this safety system anyway because it's obligated, but to spread out the costs of investment, they didn't do it right away. Later on, the Belgian railway company was saying they want to maintain this route anyway, even though if Arriva is running on the same route. They even planned to run trains twice per hour. The number of passengers on this line isn't that high, so one train per hour should be enough. Just imagine what would happen when there would be two trains of the Belgian railway company per hour plus one train of Arriva per hour. Arriva also committed they will use exactly the same amount of staff from Belgium that is being used for this line at this moment as well. So there will be no job loss at all. The costs for maintaining this line, so subsidy on the Belgian part, would be exactly the same as the Belgian railway company asks. And in return, the travelers will get newer, more modern trains. Long story short, it looks like there is a political game going on here, what is not in favor of the railway passengers and the Belgian taxpayers. The current status is that at the end of 2022, the train from Aachen to Maastricht will be continued to Liège.
So I'm here at the railway station of Maastricht in the south of Netherlands. I hope you like this video. When you like it, please give me a thumbs up. And as always, subscribe to my channel when you like to see more trip reports and, well, train videos in general. See you on my next video.